Hello everyone, I'm Adam with AEW Maine Treasure Adventures. Today, we are going to find a dinosaur fossil. Don't worry, we aren't digging in the park. I'm going to try one of the National Geographic dig kits that was sent to me. I'll put a link in the description if you want to check them out for yourself. The wind was so bad this day that none of my audio came through, so I'm doing a voiceover. It might look a little weird because my voice will not match my mouth, but it is what it is. What do you get in the kit? One dig brick with a replica specimen, one real dinosaur fossil specimen, a magnifying glass, a dig tool, a brush, the learning guide, and instructions. Interesting fact. No dinosaur fossils have ever been discovered in Maine, yet I'm still working on it. That doesn't mean that dinosaurs were never in Maine. Unfortunately, there is a gap in Maine's fossil record from about 360 million years ago to about 1 million years ago. No fossil-bearing rocks exist in Maine that have been dated to this period of time. Because of this, no dinosaur fossils have ever been discovered in Maine. I would bet money on it that dinosaurs walked in the state of Maine at one point in time. Someday, someone will find one. It'll probably be in the mud or in the swampland somewhere in the state. Today's adventure brings us up on top of Great Head, overlooking Sand Beach in Acadia National Park. We are sitting on the ledge, overlooking the beach. The first thing that I'm going to do is get the digging brick wet to make it softer and easier to dig out. I will start by using the digging tool and slowly start to get into the sand brick. When you start to uncover the fossil or item, make sure to excavate all the way around the fossil. Go slow, so you don't accidentally break the fossil. Do not try to pry out the specimen that is only partially excavated, as it could break. Patience is the key, so you don't damage it. This kit has a real genuine fossil and a replica T-Rex tooth that was molded from a real T-Rex tooth. It's been about 5 minutes that the brick has been soaking in water, so let's start digging this item out. The bricks are still pretty hard, so I'm just putting the digging tool and twisting to make a small divot in the sand, then slowly going back and forth to remove the layers a little bit at a time. I'll speed up some of our digging so you don't get too bored. The T-Rex tooth is going to be around 3.5 inches long. We will talk more about the tooth once we find it. Some interesting facts about T-Rexes. Their arms were over 3 feet long, and it's estimated that they were capable of lifting up over 400 pounds each. Some experts think that T-Rex teeth had so much bacteria stuck in them that if the bite alone didn't kill its prey, that the infection that would have come along with it would kill any wounded prey. Female T-Rexes were larger and outweighed the males by a few thousand pounds. The reason is that females had to lay several large eggs at once and therefore had bigger hips. Or maybe it was because females were better hunters than males. How are fossils formed? Fossils are animals' hard body parts, like bones, teeth, exoskeletons, and shells, are usually made when an animal dies, and its body is quickly buried in mud or sand. As more layers of sediment cover the remains, soft tissues like skin and organs rot away. The hard parts become encased in the sediment, and over time, water infused with minerals soaks into the hard material, replacing the original chemicals. Another way is by the hard parts decaying after the sediment has hardened into rock. This leaves an empty space in the rock that can be later filled by minerals that create an exact stone replica of the original parts. What are fossils? Fossils are the remains of prehistoric animals and plants. A fossil is not an actual object, like a bone or a leaf, but rather an exact copy of an original object made from minerals. It's a pretty cool process. Fossils take millions of years to form and are very important to scientists. The word fossils in Latin means dug up, and that's exactly how fossils are obtained. People dig them out of the rocks that surround them, a process called excavating. Examples of fossils include bones, teeth, shells, leaf impressions, nests, and footprints. Fossils can show us how animals changed over time and how they are related to one another. Who usually finds fossils? Anyone could find a fossil. However, fossils are often discovered by scientists that are called paleontologists. Paleontology is about more than just finding and identifying fossils. They are dedicated to understanding the process that led to the origin and extinction of all the different organisms that have lived on our planet. Paleontologists study both animals and plants, so they must have a good understanding of biology, geology, ecology, anthropology, archaeology, and computer science. They cover just about all the G's. Paleontologists spend a lot of time outside hunting for fossils, marking where they located the specimens. They spend even more of their time in a laboratory cleaning, identifying, and examining their discoveries. They use a number of different tools to clean their findings, like drills, chisels, picks, toothbrushes. They will examine the specimen under a microscope and run a number of tests on the item to find out as much information as they can. In this National Geographic Dino Dig Kit, you'll find a replica T-Rex tooth molded from a real T-Rex tooth fossil, and you'll also get a genuine dinosaur poop. It's called a coprolite. It's over 50 million years old. That's pretty crazy. This is a really cool kit. It's great for kids from 8 to 108 years old. It's fun to dig the item out, and you get to learn about fossils along the way. It's educational. This whole process took me about 12 minutes to complete. I know I could have gone a lot faster, however, I was trying to make it as realistic as possible. In a moment, I'll show you some video of the oldest, largest species that I've been able to swim with under the water. But first, let's take another look at everything you get in this kit. You get a dig brick with a replica specimen, a real dino fossil specimen, a magnifying glass, a dig tool, a brush, the learning guide, and instructions. I will add a link below if you're interested in getting one of these kits. I don't get paid for doing this video, or if you use the link to purchase one. I just think they are super cool. Currently, the best price for one of these is at Walmart for $11.88. It'll be in the toy aisle. Here are some cool examples of T-Rex fossils that have been found, and most are on display in museums. This is one of the oldest large animals that I've swam with. It's the Basking Shark. They are the second largest sharks in the world that are still alive. Fossil records of the Basking Sharks can be traced back to about 35 to 29 million years ago. This is one of our painted turtle friends that I hung out with last year. Fossil evidence shows that painted turtles have been around for 35 million years. The painted turtle is one of the most common turtle species in North America. Painted turtles must be in the water while eating. Their tongues do not move freely, so they need to be underwater to swallow. The painted turtle is the Illinois state reptile. Did you know you can tell how old a painted turtle is? You can count the rings on the painted turtle to see its age, just like you can a tree. The shell of a painted turtle is made up of 13 bone plates called chutes. When the turtle grows, it sheds the outside layers of its chutes and grows new plates underneath. Count the rings on the chutes and you'll know the age of your turtle. Let's take another look at the coprolite and the T-Rex tooth. For me and my poop find, AEW out. Here is a couple behind the scenes look at how I made this video. The outside shot was 3 weeks ago. The inside was just done. Let me show you what I was looking at. How about them apples? All right. Next one. Oh yeah. AEW out for real this time. This comes in four different languages.